Joining us now is Bayan Muna Partilist Representative Carlos Zarate. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Good morning, Christian.
Okay, first, I'd like to extend our condolences to your partilist group and, of course, to the family of Congresswoman Eufemia Culyaman. Okay, first of all, how's the Congresswoman now?
Well, she's still distraught, no? She's mourning, of course, as a mother. Kailangan niyang nagdadalamhati siya, no? Dahil nga sa pagkapaslang ng kanyang bunsong anak, no? And added to that, yung pang talagang nasaktan siya doon sa desecration na ginawa ng militar doon sa bangkay ng kanyang anak, no? Parang it was being displayed, pinarada as a trophy, no? By the military. It's now on social media, pinagpapasapasa na na parang nag-group picture yung mga nakapaslang sa kanya at nandun yung bangkay ng kanyang anak. It added, no? Doon sa sakit na naramdaman ni Eufemia.
And of course, according to the Defense Secretary, that was quite a standard operating procedure in cases like this. How do you respond to that?
That only goes to show, Christian, no? How they set aside norms even in this situation that there is a ongoing war, no? Alam naman natin na merong sinusunod rin international humanitarian law that mandates, no, combatants, no, from both sides to respect and give dignity, especially to those considered as forced to combat or yung mga napaslang na. But in this case, clearly, if this is the standard operating procedure of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, no, ay malinaw na hindi nila sinusunod yung international humanitarian law at hindi nila sinusunod yung mga conventions and treaties that the government of the Philippines is a party to. And also, we have to remember in 1998, the government of the Philippines is a signatory together with the National Democratic Front of the Philippines doon sa comprehensive agreement for the respect of human rights and international humanitarian law.
The CARIL, definitely.
Yes, Christian, you're correct.
But were you even surprised that this was done, given the viciousness of the back and forth between the rebels, their leaders, and President Duterte, and those in government?
Well, Christian, no, kahit pa siguro talagang intense na yung bakbakan or exchanges of not only ideas and accusations, counter-accusations, but civility, the norms of civility dictates that we have to observe, no, these humanitarian laws, no, even in times of war. Yun lang naman ang pinaka-basic na hinihingi natin dyan. No? While we are pushing, Christian, na magkaroon na sana ng long-term solution itong more than a five-decade-old problem ng rebellion in our country. It will not be resolved through this kind of actions, no, from the security sector, through reckless and red tagging and terrorist tagging, no, that they are doing now. And in fact, I think in the coming days, they will be emboldened to continue doing this, especially that it's already the president who red tag and terrorist tag many of us, no, especially the Makabayan Black.
So okay. Now, I'd like you to respond to this, Congressman Zarate. The impression that your group and, of course, the other supporters or sympathizers are focusing on the unfortunate use of that photo as some sort of a trophy for the military, because supposedly you're trying to take the focus away from the fact or the idea that was quite a strong proof that there was indeed, at least according to the military and to the government, that there was indeed a link between the Bayan Muna Partilist Group and the New People's Army, that you want to take the discussion away from that by focusing on the photo, unfortunate as it was, brutal and uncalled for as it was.
Well, that is not true, Christian. No? We are not dichotomizing things. No, we are just stating the fact that this is what happened after that report came out that the youngest child of Representative Culyaman was killed in a supposed encounter in Surigao del Sur. No? But going back, no, is that proof that Bayan Muna is a front of the Communist Party of the Philippines? I think it is not. No, what it has proven, Christian, ay sa panahon na ito ay marami talaga mga kababayan natin na tuloy-tuloy pa rin nilang nakikitang option yung pag-aarmas, no, dahil sa widespread poverty, oppression, injustice in this case, for example, as related to us by Eufemia Culyaman. yung kanyang bunsong napaslang ay nakita nito sa dalawang mata niya kung paanong pinaslang in September 1, 2015 yung kanilang mag-anak, yung kanilang leader, at yung kanilang executive director ng kanilang alternative schools doon sa Surigao. Kitang-kita daw nila, no? Na pinaslang sa harap nila. And until now, wala pang hustisya yung pagkamatay na yon ng kanilang mga leader. No? So, we are not, if there is somebody or there are groups that wants to divert the issue, it's the security sector, no? Trying to cover up the fact that itong mga pangyayaring ito ay siyang nagtutulak, no? Bakit marami pa rin sa ating mga kababayan ang napinili, no, na magbitbit ng armas dahil hindi natutugunan yung sinasabi nating roots of the armed conflict, which the government in itself admit, no, na siyang dapat matugunan. Like for example, the issue of landlessness, no, displacement of our indigenous peoples, the LUMAD. Eh kahit sa mga areas Christian na sa Mindanao na wala namang napapabalitan yung People's Army na di-displace ang mga LUMADs because of the intrusion, for example, of large-scale mining. Hanggang ngayon, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yan. At yan yung nagtutulak ng marami sa ating mga kababayan na to take that option.
Okay. And of course, again, we're not condoning the use of that photo, especially that incident as a trophy, whichever side the people might be on in this entire debate. But again, there are also those who are raising this issue that how come your group is too much focus on this particular incident, the fact that it was used as a trophy, quote-unquote, when in fact, supposedly, you were also quite silent in previous incidents wherein you also saw military personnel or soldiers somehow using the same or something similar after a clash with, let's say, militants or Islamist militants in parts of Mindanao.
I think, Christian, that is not true. No? We have been raising these issues. Even if kahit na yung pagpaparada ng mga supposed witnesses, no, or suspects in crimes, no, as a human rights lawyer and activist, ay talagang kinukundi na natin ito because that deprives the person, no, especially itong mga supposed suspects in the crimes, no, of their right, no, to be presumed innocent. At doon naman sa mga napapaslang, it degrades, no, it desecrates doon sa tao mismo na napaslang, no, in whatever circumstances that. Hindi lang sa ngayon namin ito nire-raise, no, that is a violation of international humanitarian law, no? Even in times of war, I think, as I mentioned earlier, we have to observe some norms of civility, no? Kahit na tuloy-tuloy na kakaroon ng punggalian sa ating bayan.
Okay. Now, in your case, did you know beforehand that the youngest child or the daughter of Congresswoman Kulyamat was part of the NPA?
No, I don't have personal knowledge of that, Christian. It was only last Sunday that when that news broke out that Jebelin was supposedly killed in an encounter, that I knew that she joined or she was in that area of Surigao del Sur.
Okay, now this next question I think was also raised during the previous Senate hearing which you attended regarding the red baiting of certain groups including Bayan Muna. In this case, the youngest daughter of the congresswoman, again, it was quite unfortunate, the fact that she was killed in an encounter between the military and the New People's Army. But the way or the option that she took, are you in favor of that? Basically, taking up arms against the government. When in fact, in your case, you're doing it in the actual parliament, in Congress. You're not taking up arms.
Yes. Yes, that's the personal choice of any person. That's their option. Dahil nga, sabi ko nga, Christian, napakaraming masalimuot na problema pa rin sa ating bayan ngayon. And they're not in a position to just condemn, no, anybody when the basis for taking that options are legitimate. No? Even President Duterte before made that kind of distinction. No? And in the same manner previously, and even up to now, we will not condemn, for example, the Moro Islamic Liberation Front or the Moro National Liberation Front or any member of those organizations for taking that option before, no? Because by doing so, ay parang sinasarahan mo na rin yung matagal na naming tinutulak, Christian, na dapat magkaroon ng political settlement itong ganitong tunggalian sa ating bayan, no? So, there are sectors of our society or members of our society that eventually, dahil hindi sila nasasapatan, no? Dahil tinutulak sila ng circumstances. For example, in the case of the daughter of Representative Kulyanat na nabanggit ko kanina, nakitang-kita ng dalawang mata niya yung pagpaslang ng kanilang mga leader, and she will take that option, then we are not in a position to condemn that.
You are not in a position to condemn that. The actions taken by the New People's Army.
We will respect, I will, and we will respect, no? Yung position, personal choice na ginawa ng mga individuals like Jebelin, anak ni Representative Kulyanat.
This is also somehow tantamount to condoning that kind of that course of action taken by some of our countrymen.
No, it's not condoning, Christian, no? Because when you say condoning, it presupposes that you are in a position to control or to stop that person from doing so. That is his personal choice or her personal choice. No, hindi mo pwedeng diktahan yung option ng isang tao or yung pagpili ng isang tao kung anong tatahakin niya, no? In our society, Christian, especially at now, no, na napakaraming problema sa ating bayan, there are several voices, no? These voices should be heard, no? And if these voices, iba-ibang daan ang tinatahak nito, no? Or pinupuntahan nito, then we just have to respect that, no? But ang sinasabi nga natin, if ang real problem ng ating bansa ngayon ay matindi pa rin ang kahirapan, no? Matindi yung landlessness, no? At tinutulak natin na sana magkaroon ito ng political settlement. Bumalik yung dalawang partido sa usapang pangkapayapaan and to address the root causes of the armed conflict. But, no? Unfortunately, there are those in the administration that wants to sabotage all this kind of path, no, of having a political settlement. Yeah, that's why it's a parang cycle, Christian, up to now.
Yeah, definitely. And I think the other question is that, is it too late for that? We can devote an entire discussion on why the peace talks under President Duterte bogged down. Hopefully not for good. But again, the window of opportunity is getting smaller. But in this case, let's also talk about the plight of the Lumads, the indigenous peoples, those communities. Because whether you like it or not, many of them are being caught in the middle, supposedly of a propaganda war. Some of them are being used by the military. Some of them are being used by the New People's Army. How do you settle this? Because at the end of the day, it's their lives that are at stake here. And we don't want them to be caught or be used by either side for their own propaganda purposes without them actually benefiting in the end.
Yes, Christian, but this problem, Christian, hindi mo pwedeng ihiwalay ito, no? Doon sa malawakang problema, no? Na dapat ay pag-usapan talaga ng both parties to the conflict, no? Hindi mo pwedeng ma-settle, for example, yung taon-taon na lang na displacement ng ating mga kapatid na Lumad dyan sa Mindanao, no? Without talking on the issue of how these resources, no, na nasa loob ng mga ancestral domains ng ating mga kapatid na Lumad ay mapakinabangan at meron silang control dito at meron silang say dito sa mga resources na ito, na ito naman ang kadahilanan ng talaga, Christian, mainly, no, bakit sila nadi-displace dyan. So I'm going back to my thesis earlier na these root causes of this armed conflict, no, can be to us, no, pwedeng pag-usapan ito for na magkaroon ng isang political settlement, and there are already advances previously dito sa usapang pangkapayapaan, but unfortunately it backed down, no, and it did not continue even as we speak now.
Yeah, definitely. And I think it's good to refresh the memory of our viewers that there was quite a momentum even before Duterte had actually assumed office. There was a lot of goodwill, but somewhere along the way negotiations bogged down, and I think it's fair to put the blame both sides. Unfortunately, Congressman Zarate, you can pin the blame on the adherents, on the supporters of the NDFP, the New People's Army, at the same time, of course, the government. Now, I'd like to go to this message coming from President Duterte last night. Did you get to see it?
Yes, a portion of it, Christian, after it was aired last night.
How do you respond to that? You were singled out in that public address that was intended to brief the nation regarding the government's response to the pandemic, and you were insulted quite heavily in that public address by the president. And excuse me for saying this, he even said even use that reference to refer to you. He used dog poop. I mean, the type of discourse that happened last night coming from the highest official, elected official in the Philippines. How do you respond to that?
Yeah, that's a classic President Duterte. No? He has been doing that in his weekly address. No? It so happened that yesterday, kami na naman yung kanyang parang flavor of the week. No? But that is not true. No? And I will not give it you know, credit or to... I know that's... I'm very sure, no, na walang katotohanan yung pinagsasabi niya. Mm-hmm. I know President Duterte, who have been as our mayor in Davao City before, as a journalist, I've been covering him as a lawyer. No, I have been representing clients, and there are several times that we have to engage with the mayor of Davao City. So, walang patutunguhan, Christian, no? If you will just papatulan mo yung mga ganong mga patutsada, dahil it will only divert the issue.
Yeah.
And the issue here really, in this past month, for example, the incompetence of the government, no, to respond to this global pandemic. No? And hindi naman kami lang nagsasabi niyan, marami. No? Kaya nagkaganito ang problema in this past typhoons, no? Ano ang nangyari sa ibang bahagi ng ating bansa? So, and even in the issue of corruption, Christian, even President Duterte admitted that going to his fifth year in office, ay matindi pa rin yung corruption dyan, even the problem of drugs. No? So, these are the things, no, na kami naman, bilang mga mambatas, ay aming obligasyon yun, no, na i-point out itong mga katiwaliang ito. No? Mm. For example, that resolution refiled to investigate the supposed anomalies with the PhilHealth, and it resulted to the House of Representatives recommending filing charges to the officials appointed by the President himself, no, to run the PhilHealth and several other issues, Christian.
Yeah,
no?
Of course.
So this should only divert the issue.
It only diverts the issue. Of course, that is the logical consequence of what the President had been saying against you and your group. Despite the legitimacy of the advocacies, whether you are left-leaning or whatever political affiliation a person might have. Of course, it's important to focus on the issue that they're trying to espouse or push for, whether that's legitimate. But even then, were you even surprised that the President went this low to insult you? And to many of his supporters, somehow the statement coming from the President unmasked you personally when he described you as a co-conspirator and you are a communist, according to the President.
I'm not surprised, no, because he has been doing that to all his critics and just anybody who criticizes the policies of the present administration, no. But once again, Christian, no, I have been saying this, no, in the Senate, no, I'm not a member of the Communist Party of the Philippines. I'm not a New People's Army. No? I'm not even a member of the National Democratic Front of the Philippines. But I admit that I'm an activist, no, even before, no. As a student and as a lawyer. And hindi ko lamang kinakakaya na aktivista ako. At that time, a leftist member of the House of Representatives. No? And we were pursuing our advocacies through parliamentary struggle. So, as I've said, this is really the danger, Christian. No? The administration is now obsessed in really connecting us to the underground movement, no, to pave the way. Probably for the eventual designation of our parties, the Bayan Muna and the Makabayan Bloc, no, as terrorist organization under the anti-terror law, no. And kaya nga kami talaga nananawagan, no, na pag-usapan na ito kahit na dyan sa Korte Suprema, ma-resolve na itong batas na ito, dahil this is the danger of that law, no. And itong sweeping accusation, malicious innuendos against us are actually being used to really link us with the underground organization without, no, even in the Senate now, two hearings already, these witnesses that they produce cannot even show competent evidence, no, credible evidence that indeed we are members and high-ranking officials of the Communist Party of the Philippines. Yeah. And we are engaged in this so-called conspiracy. Yeah. No? Matagal na lang sinasabi ito, Christian. 2 years ago, they have this Red October conspiracy of several other groups, no? what happened. No, it was proven to be not true. No, it's a lie. And again, and now they are again repeating this. No, ilang matrix na ang pinalabas nila before. No? So just to vilify those who are criticizing the government, from the church, from the political opposition. No, they have incarcerated several others for trump-up charges. Ang daming political prisoners yan, including Senator Leila De Lima and several others, even members of the press.
Yeah. So, of course, as a final point, Congressman Zarate, of course, naturally, if you're the one to accuse someone of any wrongdoing, you should be the one to present the proof. The burden of proof is with you. But this was the president talking, so I'm not sure whether or how you could extract any evidence coming from the president despite this accusation. But finally, the fact that he also described your group as a legal front in this grand conspiracy, comprising all the legal fronts that they have organized, headed by the National Democratic Front of the Philippines. Again, this was not a new accusation, but somehow do you see a contradiction in terms there, in terms of legally going after groups such as Bayan Muna, which is a partyless organization elected for 3 seats in the House of Representatives, and even if it's a front, according to the president, it's a legal one. So do you think this should also somehow lead to the argument that even if that is a front, according to the president, it's legal and that is a protection in itself?
Yes, I think what they are doing now, Christians, is really, as I mentioned earlier, they are paving the way, for the eventual, probably disqualify us from participating in the 2022 election, or for designation, no, and cripple for eventually the political opposition. Hindi naman natin maikaila, Christian, no, na yung Bayan Muna and the other members of the Makabayan Bloc they have also malawak na tagasunod and followings, no, as shown in the past elections, no. And I think this has also something to do in the 2022 election, the preparations of the administration, no, so that they will have a continuous hold to power beyond 2022, no, to cripple not only the progressive groups, but the entire political opposition, no? So okay, that they can continue their hold to power beyond 2022.
Okay, Congressman Carlo Zarate, thank you for joining us, sir.
Thank you, Christian. Good morning.